Welcome to this video for DataTier.net. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create enumerations. I thought it'd be kind of just an interesting place on my website. I'm not even sure how fast I'm going to get around to building this, but I was designing the database for my website, and I thought one interesting feature to have is just a place for people to come and say, I want an app that, you know, and they can put in the what they want, and then other visitors to my site could say, you know, vote it up or down, and if enough developers saw it, somebody might say they want to build it. So that's just what I was thinking, but for this purposes, it's just a demo. So in the database, I'm going to go ahead and show you two things real quick. Excuse me, I can't talk. Okay. I've already built my table called app wish list, and here this is all the fields that are in it. One of the fields is an app type, which is just an integer, but since our, you know, you saw our little, thought it'd be a little easier, you know, a little bit more, you know, declarative to use the enumeration than just have to look up, you know, nobody knows what one, I've had more apps than I could ever count that I had to go look up what some integer value meant because they didn't use enumerations. And in any framework, I see a lot of people use classes where they could just do this with an enum. But anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and show you in DataTier.net how to create the enumerations. So I'm going to fire up DataTier.net. I'm just running it through the exe version right now. I'm going to open up my project, Data Juggler Web. It's the project for my website. And if you want, I'll show you the 10-second preview of my building a C-sharp Blazor website. And I'm not a web developer, but I have fallen in love with Blazor. It makes me, it's like the ease of web forms without the crap of web forms that goes with it. So this is my, sorry to interrupt this video for the 30-second preview. Of course, Chrome doesn't open right. But this is all my open source projects, so I thought it'd be kind of, Google doesn't even know where my projects are because it doesn't search GitHub, so I'm at least going to put all my projects, you know, so hopefully GitHub will be able to find them. Plus, I added some services over here, you know, just for little things for, you know, I don't know if I'll ever get any business, but I'm looking for a job right now, so it doesn't hurt to have some way for someone to find you other than, you know, all the job sites or, you know, you see 100 other people apply for one job, so it's not very encouraging, but luckily I'm not in any real hurry to get a job. So anyway, back to our video. Sorry, that's my 10-second preview of my Blazor website, but I think it's kind of cool for me. Anyway, if you saw my first website 20 years ago, you would be impressed. All right, so closing this back down, that was our Visual Studio preview. And clicking on, I've already opened my project. Sorry, I go on tangents a lot. That's really the name of my company is Tangent, but it's probably taken. All right, so now we're clicking on enumerations. Now, you noticed our field name was app type. So kind of like this example here, I'm going to call my field name app type, and our enumeration name is app type enum. And I'm going to hit save. Hit done. Now, there's one other thing you need to do whenever you create an enumeration, and you only have to do this one time, and it works for every one of your tables. It's not a table-specific feature, so if you create one enumeration, you only have to do this once, or if you create 100, but click on Edit, and we're going to have to add a using statement for ObjectLibrary.Enumerations. Hit Save. And I'm going to hit save here, and I'm going to do the same thing in the readers table. So again, I'll edit the enumerations, click add. Should have copied that, but I didn't. ObjectLibrary.Enumerations. All right, hit save, and now we'll hit save here. And now I'm going to build our project again. Okay, I've already executed my stored procedure, so now I'm going to show you over here, if I look at our app wishlist table, here is now app type went from being an integer, now it's app type enum. And over here in the reader, the exact same, you know, this used to be an integer, but now it's an, you know, enumeration of app type enum. So that's all I'm going to show, but that's just real easy. So now anywhere in your, if you refer to your, you know, business object class, you know, the app type, you don't have to, you know, try to figure out what the integer value is. All right, thanks for watching. Have more videos coming soon and some Blazor tutorials, and now DataTier.net 1.3.0 has been released and videos are coming soon. I just wanted to finish my website because it's easier to make a tutorial after it's already built to show people. But DataTier.NET 1.3 now works with .NET Core. The only thing is you now have to use environment variables instead of connection strings in an app.config or a web.config. But that's my news for the day. All right, thanks for watching.